Good afternoon, students. Let us start with today with the RC lead compensating network circuit. So the aim of the experiment is to design a RC lead compensating network for the given specifications. There is a maximum phase lead and the frequency at which it occurs. Right. So this is a circuit of the RC lead compensating network. Right. So the meaning of lead network is the output voltage leads the input voltage. Right. So that is the meaning of the RC lead network here. For example, if there is a waveform, output voltage waveform like this, so if we have the variation of the output voltage, suppose if this is the input voltage, this is the input voltage, right? Then if my output voltage is starting from here, okay, in this fashion, so it is varying in this fashion. So here, with respect to the reference axis, so the output voltage has already crossed zero. You can see here, output voltage has already crossed zero, so it is ahead here, ahead of this input voltage. This is the input voltage, this is the input voltage, and this is output voltage. So output voltage has already crossed zero and it is ahead of the input voltage with respect to the ground axis or the reference axis. So we say that the output voltage leads the input voltage. So this is the meaning of one waveform leading the another, or one voltage leading the another voltage, right? Then the meaning of compensating network here is that compensating networks are used to provide certain adjustments to overcome the certain deficiencies in the circuit, right? So there may be certain phase lead or phase lag, right? So in order to provide certain positive lead, or in order to provide certain lag from the whatever is the current value to the expected value, right, to make certain adjustments, then we are making use of these compensating networks, right? So this is the introduction to the RC lead compensating network. Now coming to the CRO portion here, so this is the CRO, right? This is the CRO which we are using to observe the input and output waveforms on the screen here. These are the various positions, so we have various knobs on the front panel of the cathode ray oscilloscope. Then we have two channels here. Basically this is called a channel 1, where we have the ground and the AC and DC setting, and similarly there is second channel. Again, for the second channel also there is AC DC setting and the ground position, right? So if we want to observe the output of the circuit, then we are connecting to one of the channels. Similarly, if you want to observe the input from the signal generator, this is our signal generator, from where we can obtain different signals like sine waveforms, rectangular waveform, right, triangular waveform, okay, sawtooth waveform, different varieties of waveforms we can obtain from this signal generator. And this sine wave generator, signal generator, output is applied as input to the circuit, right? And we can observe the same signal, whatever we are collecting from this signal generator, on the cathode ray oscilloscope also, on the CRO also, right? So this is how we have the CRO, right? And if you want to observe the waveforms here, right, we have to check on the output with respect to input. Then if you want to observe the Lesage's pattern, which we will be seeing later, then we have to keep the CRO in XY mode. That is, this knob should be in pressed mode, XY mode, so that we can observe the Lesage's pattern, that is the output voltage versus input voltage, or what we call as the transfer function, right, which is nothing but the graph of output voltage versus input voltage, right? So this is just an introduction to the circuit, right? What is RC lead compensating network, right, and which are the different equipments. So you can see here the other equipments that are used. So these are the decade resistance box and the decade capacitance box. So this is the value of R1, C and R2. They are provided by the decade resistance box and the capacitance box. For providing the value, certain value of resistance, we are using the decade resistance box, what we call in short as DRB. And to provide the capacitance, required value of capacitance, we are making use of the decade capacitance box, or what we call as the DCB. Right? So in this way, this is about the initial setup of the RC lead compensating network. Welcome back, students. We were discussing about the RC lead compensating network, right? That is, we are conducting the experiment on RC lead compensating network. So here you can see R1 and C are parallel, and that parallel combination is in series with the R2 resistance, right? In the same fashion, I have connected the circuit here. This is R1 resistance. So R1 and C are in parallel. So you can see here, this is R1, one end I have connected to one end, right? Then another end I have connected to another end. So R and C, this is R, this is C. R1 and C, they are in parallel. Then one end of this is connected to, you can see here, the resistance one end, that is R1 one end, is connected to R2, right? There is a junction of R1 and C, it is connected to R2, right? Then R2 another end, it is connected to the ground. R2 another end is connected to the ground. So the output is connected across R2. So you can see here, this is where the output is connected, the second channel of the CRO to which the output is connected. So this is connected across resistance R2, across resistance R2. Fine. And what about the input? Input is connected, you can check here. So this is the input from the signal generator, right? Here we have connected it to this one end of the, that is R1, one end of the R1. So you can see here, this is one end of the R1. So here we have connected one end of the input. Another end of the input we have connected to ground, right? So another end of this input, we have connected it to ground. So this is ground connection. The black one, what we are seeing, this is the ground connection. Okay. Similarly, the input from the CRO. Okay. So here also we have connected in parallel with the input what I showed just now. So this is from the CRO. I have connected it to this point from R1. Right. Another end is connected to ground. Another end of the input channel of the CRO is connected to the ground point. You can see here. Fine, students. So this is about the connections. Right, how they are connected from the input, how we are receiving the signal to the circuit, and how we are getting the output. Now we will look into the input and output waveforms of the circuit. So this first channel is the input waveform. Now it is in first channel, right? If it is unpressed, it is channel 1. If I press it, it is channel 2. So input voltage I have maintained to, that is 2 into 4 volts, right? I slightly decrease it. So 2 divisions into 1 volt, so it is 2 volts. Now we'll check the output. So both are at same level, 1 volt level. If you want, we can check both at a stretch, right? So you can see here, X position I will move it. So you can see, as it is RC lead network, one is leading the another, right? So output is leading the input, okay? So there is a phase difference between the output and the input, fine? Now we'll take some readings. So the first reading we'll take for smaller frequency. I'll adjust the frequency here, 7. So I'll make it around 200 hertz, first value. Fine, so around 200 hertz. So around 200 hertz, how much is the output for 2 volts peak to peak input? Okay. So check the second channel. So it is X position, shift it. So it is 0.3 above and 0.5 below. So approximately 0.8 volts. So for frequency F, make the columns here, frequency. Right? So for frequency of 237 hertz approximately, how much we are getting? Output voltage, right? Output voltage V0. Vin is fixed, it is 2 volt peak to peak. Then we have to calculate the phase angle theta, that is equal to sine inverse B by A. Okay. Then calculate the magnitude, that is magnitude or the volt output magnitude in dB, that is 20 log V naught by V in. 20 log V naught by V in. So for 237 hertz, how much we are getting? 0.3 above, 0.5 below, so it is 0.8 volts. 0.8 volt peak to peak. So first calculate the 20 log V naught by V in, how much we'll get? So this comes out to minus 7.9588. Let us calculate the, this is in dB, let us calculate the phase angle. To calculate the phase angle, you have to keep the CRO in XY mode, then shift it X position, shift it x position. Okay, center it, ground positions, adjust them, x position exactly at the center, at the origin, then release the ground buttons. Now we have to check how much is B and how much is A. So you can check here. So if I move it x position, so it is cutting the y axis at approximately 1.2. So 1.2 and below 1.2. So approximately 2.4. Okay. A is 2.4, 1.2, 1.2, 2.4. How much is B then? So if I draw the Lissajous figure here, so if this is the Lissajous figure, if I am drawing, right? So this portion is B, this is B, and this where it is cutting above positions, above vertices, this is A. So sine inverse of B by A gives the phase angle theta. Fine, students. Okay, make the adjustment of the x position. Adjust the ground positions. Ground position is important here, maintaining the ground position at the center. So adjust it. Right? Then release the ground positions. Now check the where it is cutting the x. Approximately 0.2, then 0.3 below, 0.2 above, 0.3 below. So it is approximately 0.5. Okay, so this B is 0.5. So sine inverse of 0.5 divided by 2.4, which 12 degrees. Okay, so at 237 hertz we are getting 12 degrees. Right, now next let us check for higher frequency range for 1 kilohertz. I'll adjust the frequency to 1 kilohertz. So this is 1 kilohertz, right? Is it not? 1 kilohertz frequency. Now let us check the output voltage and the phase angle. It's 1.2, 1.2, 1.2. X position you just check. So it is 1.2. Then below position, below the ground level also 1.2.4 it is. So it is 2.4 volt peak to peak. Correct? So for 1 kilohertz. For 1 kilohertz. Next, find the 20 log V naught by V in. So it is 1.2, 1.2.4, then 2.4 into 0.5, that we didn't consider here. So 2.4 into 0.5, because it is at 0.5 position here, you can see channel 2. So 2.4 into 0.5, that comes out to 1.2 volts. So 1.2 volt peak to peak. So that is 20 log V naught by V in. So it is 20 log of V naught is 1.2, this divided by 2 volts peak to peak. V in is 2 volts peak to peak. So this comes out to -4.4369 dB. Let us just calculate the phase angle. So phase angle, we have to keep it in XY mode, then adjust the X position. Fine. So this is a Lissajous pattern, just I can see here. So ground it first, so center it, then release the ground positions. Now it is, you can see upper position is 1 1, so it is how much? 1 plus 1 2, right? 2, right? So theta is sine inverse of B by A. A is how much? 2, right? What about B? B is, you can see 0.5 0.4, this is 0.5 where it is cutting, this is also 0.5. so 0.5 plus 0.5 is 1, so B is 1. So sine inverse of 1 by 2, sine inverse of 1 by 2, just check, shift sine inverse of 1 divided by 2, so this comes out to 30 degrees. So this is what we have designed. We have designed for the maximum phase angle of 30 degrees at 1 kilohertz frequency. So now that means what? As per the design, our rig up or conduction of the experiment is verifying. That is, we are getting the maximum phase angle of 30 degrees at exactly designed frequency of 1 kilohertz. Right? Now this is how we are getting the readings. So similarly, you have to conduct the readings, to conduct the experiment for different readings, you can take up till maximum of 1 megahertz or 10 megahertz. You have to go on taking the readings of output voltage, calculate the magnitude in dB, then calculate the phase angle. Right? right? Finally, you have to plot the characteristics. If you plot the characteristics of the phase angle, if you plot the characteristics of the phase angle versus frequency, phase angle versus frequency, then as you increase the frequency, the phase angle first increases, right? So at exactly at 1 kilohertz it is maximum 30 degrees. So as you further decrease the frequency, the phase angle will also decrease, right? Then you can see the magnitude in dB. First it will be like this. So if you plot the graph of magnitude in dB versus frequency, so as the frequency increases, first the magnitude also increases in dB, then after further increase in frequency it will remain constant, right? So this is how we'll get the response for the magnitude characteristics, and this is the response for the frequency characteristics. Fine students, so I hope everybody have understood the experiment. If there are any queries, send your queries to us so that we will clarify your queries. Thank you.